dream on his wife. Boy, you're gonna love 17. Boy, you do some stupid things. You gonna try to kiss the front porch way too fast.
A very holy time, loud time too, when this family discharges the responsibility over to this groom. The care and responsibility of the father giving the bride to the groom. Who gives this woman to be married to this man? Josh and Gillian have requested that we marry them today. Actually, God marries them. And I say to you, Josh, in taking this woman you hold by your hand to be your lawful and wedded wife, before God and these witnesses present today, do you promise to love her, to honor her, to cherish her, and leaving all others, cleave only unto Gillian, and be to her in all things a true and faithful husband, so long as you both shall live? Do you so promise? Gillian, in taking this man you hold by your hand, by your arm, his arm, to be your lawful and wedded husband before God and the witnesses today, do you promise to love Josh, to honor Josh, cherish him, and leaving all others, cleave only unto Josh, and to be to him a wife in all things, a true and faithful wife, as long as you both shall live? Let's pray for these two. Father, it is a joy and a privilege to be a part of your grand idea of marriage. And we pray your blessing on Josh and Gillian as they speak to each other in your presence, and they say their vows to each other, and they remember in their hearts, this is your idea, marriage. We love you and praise you for their lives that have been so effective apart. But we pray now that it would be very, very effective for you and your kingdom and your love and your grace as they come together today and be lawfully wedded before you. We praise you and thank you for marriage. In Jesus' name, amen. May you be seated. In order to understand what we're doing today, we need to think about the mind of the Lord, the mind behind marriage. And Josh and Gillian, I'm going to share a few things before you make your vows. And they're going to make their own vows today, wedding and wedding vows, and I leave them in ring vows. This is an important and a great time because we're thinking about the mind behind marriage is the Lord Jesus Christ, our God, that we love so much. And the first thing that we see in the Bible is the imitation that he had in his mind. He created us his own image, husband and wife, male and female. And he says in the Bible, be imitators of me as dear children, dearly loved children. So I hope you keep that in mind as you go through life together, that you want to be imitators of God. Paul said, follow me as I follow Christ. So we say to each other different times, you know, and just remind each other, we're following Jesus, thanking him for saving us, and we're going to minister together, carry out the mission of marriage together. Not only imitation, but the first great commission was this. God blessed them and said to them, be fruitful and multiply, fill the earth. Now, what's that talking about? Well, the first great commission was the commission to, if God so desires, to open the womb that you all have children. And I hope you'll be open to that. Whatever God has for you to have children. That word fruitful means to increase after your kind, male and female. Multiply. You can't multiply if you're not male and female. Multiply means increase with exceeding abundance of children. Boy, that's exciting. And replenish the earth, that means to fill up the world to overflowing. Why? Because God seeks worshipers to worship. Created in his own image, he wants us to worship. So, if God so desires, I hope you'll be open to have children. Imitation, commission, appropriation, incompletion. God created incompletion. That we need, most of us need a wife or a husband. Not everybody, but most of us. The Lord said it's not good that man should be alone. Incompletion. I will make a helper comparable to him. The Lord caused a deep sleep to fall on Adam, and he slept. He took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh in his place. So thank the Lord for incompletion. But you need each other. Okay? Not only incompletion, but attraction. You're attracted to each other. Not just physically, but emotionally. You need someone to complete you. But attraction. And then the Lord took the rib which he had taken from man and he made a woman and brought her to the man. And then in the Hebrew it says ish, for the man, and the woman is Isha. So I maybe thought that maybe Adam, when he saw Eve, he went, ah, it's great to be attracted to each other. And then the anticipation. I hope you learn about life. Always wanting to be with one another, serve one another, anticipation. Adam said, this is now bone of my bone, flesh of my flesh. You should probably call it woe man. Woe man means out of man. Taken out of man, therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and cleave to one another, be joined to one another. So anticipate, a life of anticipation, being apart, being together, be awesome. And then the completion. The Bible says they shall become one flesh. And marriage is to be honored above all of God's design. That's what the Bible says. And God himself says, I will judge the adulterer and the whoremonger. Why? Marriage is the foundation, fabric of a God-blessed home, a God-blessed society. And so these two come together with that holy purpose of completion. And then satisfaction. Scripture says they were both naked, the man and his wife, and were not ashamed. Isn't that awesome? It's a beautiful thing. This is God's idea, to be able to be together and not have guilt. You know, the height of enjoyment of anything is that we do it with a clear conscience. There's no guilt. And with God, there's no guilt. And we do it His way. And that's a wonderful, wonderful thing. So we got imitation, permission, completion, attraction, anticipation, all of this in marriage, completion, satisfaction, and in salvation. That's an often there. Why? Picture Christ, the Christ, picture the church. And here they are. The two shall become one flesh. Paul said, this is a great mystery, but I speak about Christ and the church. So wherever you go, whatever you do, you have a mandate. Be like Jesus, be like the church. Responding, grateful, loving, submissive, always thankful church. Husbands, love your wives, just as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for her. Wives, submit to your own husbands as to the Lord. Marriage is to be a human object lesson of the divine relationship between the Savior and the saved. Amen. Isn't that a good thing? And then lastly, the communion. The communion. The scripture says that you come together to serve the Lord in mind, will, emotion, spirit, soul, and body. And the scripture says, Jesus said, I'll be with you always, even to the end of the age. The mind of marriage. And I know you both are grateful for that. And we've talked about it different times, maybe sermonized on it different times. So it's been great to see you all come together. How God brought you together when I was here as the interim pastor. What a joy. And how grateful you were for the Word of God and the, not only the Word of God, but the written Word of God, but the living Word of God, the Lord Jesus. Now, these two are going to turn and face one another, and they're going to exchange their wedding vows. Okay? I need to help.
Give you these promises forever. I promise to encourage our faith in God, because through this there is no greater love. I promise to encourage your hope and compassion, because that is what makes you extraordinary. I promise to nurture your dreams, because through them your soul shines. I promise to shoulder our challenges, for there is nothing we cannot face if we stand together. Lastly, I promise to you a love and trust like no other. For one lifetime with you can never be enough. In fulfilling these promises, we will provide ourselves a love for eternity. I have received no greater gift and have no greater gift to give. Like this ring, my love has no beginning or end. And I give you all that I am and all that I shall become.
Amen and amen. How beautiful and how loving. You received that amen, right?
When we first met, someone told me that they could see a fire and desire in my eyes for you. It's a look and a feeling I have never experienced before. Although it took some time for us to find our way to each other, you never gave up on me or the idea of us being together, and neither did I. We are what most people would claim to be absolutely crazy to move across the state, leaving our families behind and only having each other to a small town named Rowland after only dating for 3 months. I think it's safe to say that we have beaten our label. Over the past year and a half, we have grown and become the adults we appear to be. Most of all, we have been each other's biggest supporter, motivator, calmer, and happiness. Before we met, I didn't know what it truly meant to love someone and to truly be loved back. When we met, you saw past all of my fronts and that I put up to avoid any more hurt. You saw the goodness and selflessness in me that was either taken advantage of or overlooked. You saw the person that I was who I never thought I could be. I am good enough in your eyes, and you show me that I deserve to be loved. In a world like ours, this is something to be cherished and everlasting. So today I vow to love you unconditionally and eternally, for we are able to love because God first loved us. I vow to always encourage and support you, no matter where life takes us, wherever you go, I go. I vow to be the one to lift you up on the bad days and share in your happiness on the good days. Joshua Thomas Rowland, I have loved you from the moment I met you, and it is my honor and admiration to be your wife. Love always. More.
Wow, that's awesome. God bless you both. Scripture says that she is your companion, Josh, and the life of your covenant. Covenant means to cut. It means that God cut himself for our sins. He took credit on the cross for us. And so we are a picture here of sacrificial love with Josh and responding in appreciating love. It's a covenant based on trust between the parties. A contract is based on distrust. A covenant is based on unlimited responsibility. Contract is based on limited liability. A covenant cannot be broken if new circumstances occur, but a contract can be voided by mutual consent. Now we're going to make the ring vows, and so if you would get the ring there, back to Josh from the ring bearer, and hold that for a moment while I explain the meaning of the ring. Josh, before you put the ring on Gillian's finger, the ring is a symbol here. When you all look at your rings, when God made a covenant with Noah, he put a symbol in the sky, a rainbow. And when you look at the rainbow from the sky, it is a circle. It was a continual reminder to God of the covenant that he had made with mankind. In Scripture, the ring is also a symbol of authority and the resources. You put their ring and they endorse it. That means them, their life, and their resources are involved in the transfer when the ring was used to solidify an agreement. When you look at your rings, I hope you will remember, remind you that God has made covenant with you through the Lord Jesus Christ. He was the Lamb that took your sin, and you can know you're completely and totally forgiven. Past, present, future sin, because of the love of God. In John 3:16, we all know. And so there it is, the picture. When you look at that, that you make covenant with each other today. And you're following the covenant maker and the covenant keeper, our Lord God. And Jesus said, I will never leave you or abandon you. Isn't that wonderful? And you've all said saying that to each other today. Even through the good and the bad, you're going to hang in there together. Josh, why don't you repeat this? Put this on your bride's ring finger, if you would, and repeat this after me. This ring is a picture of my love for you. I give it to you, Jillian, to wear in joy. I give it in humble gratitude that Jesus led us together. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Jillian, you have a token of your vows today. Just remember, place that ring on his ring finger and repeat after me. Josh, this ring is a picture of my love for you. I give it to you to wear with joy I give it in humble gratitude that Jesus led us together. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. You know, one of the first things that they could do today, and we will do it right now, is invite you. If you have never received Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, you've heard them confess their vows together, their love for each other. When God died on the cross of Christ, the Scripture says He confessed it is finished. And it's an offering to you today to be saved through Jesus, through the Christ, the Messiah, fulfilled all the prophecies of the Bible, hundreds of years written before, fulfilled them all. So we invite you today. I believe Josh and Jamie would invite you. I'm inviting you to confess with your mouth that Jesus will be your Lord. Believe in your heart that God judged Him for you. He judged your sin. And that God raised Him from the dead. He defeated the penalty of our sin, death. And He's offering that to you. I hope you right now in a moment, with your eyes open even, just say, God, I'm not sure I'm saved, but I want to be. Ask Him to come into your heart and save you. On the authority of the Bible and as a minister of the gospel, this could be your day, your first fruit of these two lives, that they know people will come to know you, come to know the Lord as personal Savior. Josh and Gillian, for as much then as you have covenanted together, according to the teachings of the Scriptures, the Bible, and the laws of this state, the state of South Carolina, I, a representative of the state of South Carolina, and a minister of the gospel, declare that you are husband and wife. What therefore God has joined together, let not man separate. Josh, you may kiss your bride. And Gillian, you may kiss your husband. The Lord to bless this union. Father, we're so grateful today for your love and grace in Josh and Jacob's life, and we just thrill at their anticipation, their completion, their complete life together. Just be joyful, and even in the bad days, they'll say, I forgive you, I've been forgiven, and they'll continue to be a picture of Christ in the church that you've given them today. We love you and praise you for what you're going to do. In Jesus' name, amen. It's my joy and privilege today to present the latest picture of our Christ and the church, Josh and Gillian Rowland. Everything you said we do has been said and done. You are invited to a reception at Greenbrier Farms, 766 West Store Road. You're local, and they have asked that you go ahead and begin your fellowship around the food. Go ahead and eat, start eating. We're going to have your private prayer together, or just go ahead and start eating, and the family will join you as soon as they finish the pictures here in the worship center. God bless you. You're dismissed.